holes. My worst existential nightmare. Black holes vary in size, but are usually several times the mass of our own sun. But what if somehow, some way, we could generate a black hole on Earth? And what if it opened up in New York City? Bop, bop. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all manner of queries, especially when it comes to a good old black hole. We love black hole chat. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, providing my own sound effects, and today I'm asking, what if a black hole appeared in New York City? It's like Home Alone 2 lost in New York, except instead of having fun and lols in the Big Apple is getting gobbled up by a vagrant black hole. Sure. Before we get into this video though, I want to know if you have ever been to New York. I went recently. Here's a picture of me wearing a big hat outside the Rockefeller Center. Fun story, that hat kept on blowing off my head because the buildings create wind tunnels. It was pretty useless, and if there was a black hole in NYC, I'd be sure to toss that stupid hat in it first. Good. Great. Also, do leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend, and if you aren't yet subscribed to Life's Biggest Questions, now's your time to do so. Okay. Black holes. This week marked the first ever time a black hole was photographed. Let's have a wee look-see, shall we? So, Shepard Dolman of Harvard University said, "We have seen what we thought was unseeable. While there are thought to be around 100 million black holes in our galaxy, the Milky Way alone, they aren't just happened upon. The closest black hole we know of is V616 Monocerotis. It's located 3,000 light years away and has between 9 to 13 times the mass of our sun. There are two definitive types of black hole, supermassive and stellar mass, as well as a speculative third type, microscopic black holes. We'll get to those. Supermassive black holes are at the heart of every galaxy and have the mass of millions of stars, and stellar mass black holes are still dense, but on a much smaller scale, with the mass of dozens of stars, sometimes even hundreds. Oh, and stellar mass black holes can move. So before we get any wild ideas about supermassive black holes and stellar mass black holes, let's just rule them out right away. They're both far too big and dense to pop up in Manhattan. If they came anywhere near our solar system, the entire planet would be gobbled up in a heartbeat, or less. But what of microscopic black holes? Well, these are still somewhat hypothetical, although they were discussed at length by the late great Stephen Hawking. All hail the king. So, what if a little black hole, say the size of a quarter or a tenpence piece, opened up in New York City? A wee little black hole, just a tiny thing. Well, it would be absolute chaos. Isn't that always the answer? It is. Now, it's important to mention here that research and studies into black holes hasn't necessarily drawn definitive conclusions, just informed speculation. Of course, we've never got close enough to a black hole to really study it, and we should actually probably thank our lucky stars for that. If a coin-sized black hole opened up in New York City, it would be utter chaos. That's Act 1, closely followed by death and destruction in Act 2, and a third act of conceptual woe. Black holes are super dense in their nature. If a coin-sized black hole opened up anywhere on Earth, it would have a mass greater than that of the Earth itself, which would mean that we would be drawn into it. Classic black hole behavior. Black holes only get bigger the more they consume, too. Within seconds, the black hole would suck in everything within a 1 mile radius, and it would keep on drawing in things atom by atom with its super mass. Goodbye Central Park, goodbye Times Square, goodbye Trump Tower, goodbye Statue of Liberty. It wouldn't be long until the five boroughs were totally consumed, and it started drawing in matter from nearby towns, cities, countries, and beyond. The location of the hole being in New York City is kind of irrelevant. If one opened up anywhere on Earth, we would kind of be screwed anyway, but on ever so slightly different time frames. Of course, what it's closest to will be sucked in first, but eventually Earth would start orbiting the more massive black hole and would be gobbled up part by part. The first to go would be the crust, which houses all life, followed by the mantle, which is hot, hot, hot. According to a very informative In a Nutshell video by Kurzgesagt, the Earth would be a scatter disk of hot rocks orbiting a black hole until it swallowed us entirely. The moon would orbit this black hole and may well be swallowed up too. There's a chance it could pull in asteroids from the asteroid belt, but assuming the hole was just coin-sized and slightly above Earth mass, it wouldn't draw in other planets in our solar system. It would just stay put, orbiting the sun, just like we did, but again, we would all be dead. No worries though, a black hole isn't just going to open up in New York, or anywhere for that matter. The formation of black holes only comes from very massive entities collapsing in on themselves. Even our sun isn't big enough to create a black hole when it reaches its end of life phase. But wait a second. A lot of people have speculated that CERN's super expensive and super powerful Large Hadron Collider could cause a black hole. The Large Hadron Collider is a 17-mile-long superconducting machine that can smash protons together at nearing the speed of light. The super machine found the Boston Higgs particle, the so-called God particle, and many, once again, do speculate that it will be capable of creating a micro black hole. While that may be the case, it's quite likely that any hole created would be so tiny and would evaporate so quickly as a result of Hawking radiation. A super comforting sentence for you guys from the NASA website on the matter. A micro black hole could shoot down through the center of the Earth and out of the other side without causing any damage, just as easily as it could shoot up through 300 feet of the Swiss countryside. Either way, it would end up in the near vacuum of space, where the odds of it touching and sucking in any matter so that it could grow into a menace would be smaller still. So, like, are NASA saying that we could create a tiny black hole? Cause if so, like, worried? Maybe? Maybe not. Even if that was the case, we would need to adjust our video title to be "What if a black hole appeared in Switzerland?" Because that's where the Hadron Beastie is. But again, don't worry. Or maybe do. But like, probably don't. Okay, that's about enough of that. I was gonna go into the whole other dimension at the end of the black hole thing, but I really do think that is just too much for one day. Put your phones down. Stop worrying about black holes. They're probably not gonna suck you up. Again. Probably. Do let me know what you thought of this video in the comments section down below. Before I go, I do just want to read some comments from one of my most recent videos, "What if the sun never set?" Thomas Turner said, "Then it would be like the British Empire." Oh wait, yes, I did make that joke, or I guess, is it even a joke these days? It's kind of collapsing more and more in on itself, like a black hole. Black Hole Britain. Be a good band name. Although a joke I didn't make came from Dagon Ward. They said, "What if the sun never set?" Well, that is an unsettling thought. I like what you did there. Grim Hades said, "The moon does spin. It takes approximately 27 days to make one full rotation. We just don't see it because of the lock." Now, I think what you're trying to get at here is that yes, the moon does orbit the Earth, but it doesn't spin on its axis like Earth does. It's different. Thank you for watching this video. It's time for it to set. Good. Great. Once again, do leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. Stay tuned for the next video. But until then, be curious, be alert, never ever stop questioning.